Are you looking for a low-cost 3D printer that can hold its own among the bigger boys? The best 3D printer, under $200, 2018? Well, yeah, you ain't getting none of that here. This is a Maker's Muse review of the Creality Ender 3. Warts and all, let's get started. How's it going, guys? Angus here from Maker's Muse, and this is the hype printer of the moment, the Ender 3. From Creality, and for good reason. Creality are the creators of the legendary CR10, and its slightly smaller brother, the CR10 Mini, was one of my picks for the budget makerspace project. The Ender 3 is a little bit different though, so let's break it down. The machine has a print volume of 220 by 220 by 250, so don't let the lower price fool you. This thing can print larger than most other i3s, and that includes the Prusa Mark III. It has a heated print bed, Bowden extruder, and the files are loaded via the included microSD card, or you can tether it via the mini USB port. Creality printers usually come flat packed, requiring some basic assembly, but the Ender 3 comes in a lot more parts, so it's better classed as a kit. The hard parts are done for you, however, which is awesome, leaving you to put together the main components and plug everything together. I did the whole thing on stream over at Maker's Muse Live, and then I went in totally blind. It's probably the nicest kit I've ever assembled, to be honest, and well worth the price savings over a ready-to-run machine. Chinese manufacturers such as Creality have come a very long way in a short amount of time. You won't find a single 3D printed part in the kit, with everything being sheet metal, aluminium extrusions, or injection molded plastic. Really, really nice, and something some other manufacturers will start having to consider if they want to compete in this new era of hobby 3D printers. The Ender 3 has a heated aluminium bed with fake build tack from factory, and sadly, no auto bed leveling. I would really like to see that sort of thing become standard. It just makes the machine so much easier to use, and honestly, the slight price increase would be totally worth it to me. But instead, we've got the bog standard 4-point spring-loaded bed with these comically oversized bed leveling adjustment wheels. They're great for fine adjustment, however, despite their huge size, the rear ones are still quite difficult to access, and I found you really have to loosen them if you want the nozzle to be even close to reaching the bed. Creality was one of the first companies to really push for V-rollers and appropriately matched V-slot extrusion, so it's no surprise to see it here again on all axes. My machine was rolling tight from factory, however, if you find you need to adjust yours, it's easy to do with the included wrench on the eccentric nut. In fact, I'm not sure if mine might have been adjusted to be too tight because the rollers are already displaying some signs of excessive wear. It is possible to stuff up V-slot and get the angle slightly wrong, so I'll be keeping a close eye on that to watch how it develops. Alrighty then, let's get on to the good stuff, the print quality. Well, like I said, this review is warts and all, and here's where it goes horribly wrong. The first attempt at the test print on the SD card led to the Bowden tube popping free from the coupler. I pushed it back in place, and it popped free again. Great. You see, Bowden-style extruders build up a lot of pressure in the PTFE tube, and if they're not up to the task of being held in place with the couplers, they just let go. Turns out this coupler was particularly rubbish, and the PTFE tube supplied was quite slippery and soft. It just wasn't holding. Luckily, I had another type of coupler on hand from another machine with really nice aggressive metal teeth to grab onto the tube, and it did a really good job at securing the PTFE so I can complete the test model on the included microSD card. So while the test model printed fine, let's be honest, it's a very safe 3D print. You'd be hard pressed to stuff it up. My first prints were based off the CR10 mini profile I had in Simplify 3D, and well, the prints sucked. They sucked hard. Mega stringing and insane under extrusion. I catted this coaster design and I tried different speeds, different multipliers, different temperatures, different slices, you name it. Crap results every time. In fact, identical G-code provided varying extrusions depending on how fast I set the print speed on the printer. Awesome. Look, those in the know will already have diagnosed this issue, but what if you're just a newcomer to 3D printing? The Ender 3 is priced for that my first 3D printer market. Well, it turns out I wasn't the only one experiencing this issue, and Chuck Hellebuck over on his channel produced a video highlighting the exact cause and solution. It turns out the PTFE tube in the Ender 3 and other Creality machines butts up against the nozzle in the hot end, and if it's not perfectly flush, then molten plastic can pool in the gap, ruining the already fairly average flow accuracy of the Bowden tube design. You can push this down as hard as you like, which is what I was trying to do, but it gets worse over time. Why? Because the coupler on the extruder side wasn't holding properly either. It was slowly backing out, causing the problem to reoccur after a short period of printing. The solution, and something I would recommend to just avoid running into this problem altogether, is to order two high quality couplers that replace the ones that this machine comes with when you order the machine, and replace them from day one. During my tests, I also replaced the stock PTFE tube with precision Capricorn tubing, which is this blue stuff. Probably overkill, but this plus the new couplers have finally solved my issues. The print surface is also gone on my machine now as well, as you'll notice. What I found was that when homing the Z-axis, I found the tiny low-cost limit switch to be less than accurate enough. And for one print, it went just a bit too close and the first layer welded to the fake build tack. This was after spending a very long time to get it perfect for previous prints, mind you, it just wasn't repeatable. So I give you fair warning, removing the stock print surface is incredibly painful. For me, the plastic sheet lifted free and delaminated from the adhesive backing, leaving me with the job of peeling and dissolving the adhesive away from the metal plate with isopropyl alcohol. I then got this clean and replaced it with this magnetic print surface called the Easy Peelsy, which I reviewed here. It's great because if a surface becomes eventually damaged, you can just put another top sheet on. They're magnetically attached and you don't have to bother replacing the adhesive backed magnetic sheet that the top surface attaches to. I really like that. The leveling springs are also more than long enough to account for this increased thickness, so it's an upgrade that I would personally recommend. However, with printing issues finally resolved, I settled on a simplified 3D profile based off Frank's Cura settings, thanks man, and yeah, prints went from this to this. This Deathclaw head at 0.15 is perhaps still a little bit fuzzy, but the stringing nightmare is over. Similarly, in overhang tests, I was able to reduce it down to just fine wisps. The Geyer Anderson cat is one of my favorite test prints to analyze print quality, and similarly, it came out quite nice at 0.2mm layer heights in a generic gray PLA. There is some evidence of layer inaccuracies and artifacts running up the surface, which alerted me to a spot on the rollers for Y that doesn't run super smooth. You can feel it kind of bumping or catching at a certain point as it moves back and forth. So I highly recommend checking your rollers for damage and making sure the V slot is perfectly clean to ensure you don't encounter artifacts like this. The seams on this model are pretty ugly too. I mean, I probably could fine tune and tweak the slicer settings just a little bit better in terms of retraction, but this is the kind of thing you will fight with a Bowden style extruder, and it's just something I'll probably have to live with. I also did a PETG version in this awesome neon green, and honestly, I think I might prefer it over the PLA print. Again, it's a little bit wispy and stringy, but it looks really nice, and I might actually start printing more in PETG in the future if this is the sort of results I can expect. Wanting to throw something with dimensional accuracy at the machine, I printed this puzzle cube, and although it's pretty tight, it does work. This is with a 0.3mm clearance, so keep that in mind if you're trying to print parts that assemble together. So overall, it's a rough print, but I would give it a pass. Finally, a stress test was required, so enter the Easter egg torture test. Print quality is definitely average on this one, with a bit of ghosting and again, those nasty retraction sites. But in all fairness, the parts do turn, which is difficult to reproduce on an FDM 3D printer, although it definitely would have fused at the original scale. This is 200%. And I had printed the puzzle cubes on zero infill and didn't update them for this model, so the stuff up at the bottom with the infill there, that's completely my bad, but the rest is a reflection on the sort of print quality I'm getting off my Ender 3. Alrighty then, let's conclude this saga. Do I recommend the Ender 3 from Creality? Well, the price point is super difficult to beat. Regularly being on sale for below $200 US, it's pretty crazy for the print volume offered, as well as having a heated bed. It's also got power out recovery too, which is important to a lot of people, but honestly, I dislike the extruded design used. I just feel that there's too many unknowns that can affect print quality and make fine-tuning really difficult. There's not much reason for this design to use a Bowden. There's room for a direct driven extruder, and something where the PTFE goes right down into the nozzle, like the extruders on the Wanhao i3, for example, would definitely be my preference. I also don't like micro SD cards in 3D printers either. They're fiddly and annoying, and I did find the one provided wouldn't always play nice with my adapters, but a simple micro SD to full-size SD adapter fixes that issue. It's a really small thing to complain about, I know. I honestly think that quality control is mostly to blame for my initial experience with the Ender 3, and they led me down a wild goose chase. I'm not gonna lie, when it came to trying to troubleshoot what was going on, when it was something as simple as just changing the couplers from the beginning. So I would love to see Creality just do a bit better in the quality control department and use higher quality couplers and probably PTFE to avoid this simple issue that would have been quite a significant barrier for a newcomer to 3D printing on an overall quite good machine, especially for the price point. Because that's what I'm all about. I want people to have positive experiences with 3D printing, and this machine is, as I said, one of the best kits I've ever assembled, and I do mean that. Even the mains wiring is pre-wired and safely hidden, which is a big thumbs up to me, so just fix those issues, please. With all that in mind, you can find a link below to pick one up using our affiliate code with GearVest, or choose not to, that's totally cool. For me, I'll probably be swapping this extruder and hot end out for something else, so keep an eye out for a video on that in future, and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss it. As always on Maker's Muse, this review has been my opinion and no money has changed hands. In fact, I told GearVest I wasn't actually planning to do a review, I was just gonna use it in projects, but here we are anyway. I felt it was important to give you my experiences in the sea of other Ender 3 reviews. It is my aim to empower your creativity through technology, and I do look forward to seeing you again very shortly here on Maker's Muse. Catch you later, guys. Bye. In the latter half of the 20th century, a man has sent rockets into deep space. He has placed satellites into orbit. He has actually...